Hello, good day everybody, and welcome to Zodiac Cup. This is a game I played last Sunday, so I've been delaying this replay for a while, I've been reformatting my computer and try to get it to work properly and such. But here we are. I am Largo, please, spawning as Orange Zerg in the bottom left position. In the top right position we have Flixa, spawning as the Pink Terra, so this will be a CVT, as you can see, quite easily. And as usual, there's nothing going on at the beginning here, just getting some drones. And this is actually from the second round. It was quite a few not that many, it wasn't a full bracket, so I actually started in the second round, that is why this is from that series, not from the first round where I usually am knocked out. And I will, as always, load up one game at a time. I will probably, I don't know how I will do it this time, but usually I am knocked out in the first round, so we'll see if I will be able to actually perform any better this tournament. And I am finally scouting up here. What I see, I do see one gas, I did see one barracks on the way, did not see a second started. So everything is fine right now. I do see this SCV here being annoying. If you look at the production tab, my spawning pool is on the way at least. And here we go, gas, spawning pool. And he's scouting around, but doesn't see anything special here at all. So he will probably go down to be annoying once again. No, he's actually trying to hide up here. And what could you do with an SCV? You could, of course, build, I think, up here. You could build a bunker, and I would have no idea. You could actually almost build a base there. So that would be interesting to see. And I'm not really doing anything. I was able to save my drone and sneak back home. And he actually came down with a second SCV. Yeah, that's the one who chased me down, I think. And this is something I'll try to work on, to be able to actually pull the drones off and get it to zero, instead of gathering those extra that could be minerals. He's still there chilling, and I'm able to get my expansion down, and of course this overlord is going the perfect path to discover this SCV, and I'm very pleased with that. Getting my speed, getting my expansion, getting my queens, well, queen, rather than queens, injecting, and now I will try to kill this SCV, of course. You do not want to have that one running around, and there we go, it goes down, and I am so happy, so happy. And in the meantime, in his base, what is going on over here? He is getting a factory, so he's going in more of a tech path, rather than massing out units, and he's switching over the reactor to the factory, which usually means double Hellions, and as you can see, he's, that's not right. Well, he has not mastered this build, that's one thing I am sure of, because he shouldn't be able to queue up that many things done, which means that he could probably get this out earlier if he tried to refine it, but well, that's not my biggest problem right now. And he's starting to produce a lot of Hellions here, and I'm flying in here. I want to see what's going on. What did I see? I did see everything that I had wanted to see. I did see a factory, I did see a barracks, and that is about it. And he's planning on expanding here, and in the meantime he's going out with his Hellions to be annoying. My poor Zergling will die. There we go. I'm trying to get up a spine crawler. Should probably get, yes, I got one in the main as well. Probably hide it here in the back. Perfect. I'm trying to gear up here to be able to fend this off. 12 Zerglings is on the way. I'm trying to join the creep here as well to be able to move around very fast. And I do see that where he is. And in the meantime, I'm not really doing anything. I'm getting my lair. That is always nice. I'm not injecting. Why am I not injecting? Come on! Inject! Inject! That is why I'm not injecting. Of course, he will try to sneak into my main here, do some damage, but I'm okay with that. Let's see how much damage he's able to deal. If you look at the units lost tab, he actually only killed two workers with four Hellions, so that was definitely a win for me. And in the meantime, I'm producing 12 drones right now. That is, of course, very, very nice. And in the meantime, I'm just poking up here to see what's going on. And I was kind of suspecting that he would expand, since I poked in and did not see any starport at all. Let's see what's he getting now. More barracks. So I got two barracks and one factory. And of course, this will hopefully play. Let's see, did I see the command center? Yes, I did. I saw the tank as well, so I kind of know what's going on. Since he is producing tanks, I assume that he's not going tank banshee at this stage of the game from one base. Especially not when he's using four harvesters in one refinery and two in the other. Not really sure if I agree with that, and it's of course a mistake. Let's see how I'm doing. It's good to check this. I'm getting my two second guesses here. Starting to knock down destructible rocks as well to be able to come on. Of course, I'm not getting enough drones either, just to be annoying. This is something you should make sure that you do right, because you want three. Well, in some very, very thin, lean builds, you might actually just want two. There we go, I finally find it out. And he's scanning, and I'm not injecting as good as I should or could. And my spire is finally up. I'm getting double evolution chamber as well to get some upgrades. And six mutalisks are on the way. That is neat. Let's see, what will I actually get in there? Well, I'm low on gas. I'm getting my baneling snaps, getting attack speed. No, of course not. Getting attack plus one. That is the right way to say that. And I'm gearing up to take a third base as well. As you can see, my money's starting to climb quite heavily here, and I can't really do anything about it. Could actually use quite a few more drones, at least five more drones maybe on that base. This one's looking fine. And he's moving out here with a quite strong force, actually. And these units will have the ability to do a lot of damage, but I am trying to prepare her. I'm getting a lot of Zerglings. My Banning's Nest is almost done, and my Mutalisks are just flying straight into his base, and I am able to deal a lot of damage. If you look at this, this is such a huge amount of damage. You shouldn't be able to do that with just a few Mutalisks, but I was pleased with that, until I realized, well, he is sieging up at my natural, so I should probably... First of all, you always want to sacrifice your queen, because well, you can. Decide to pull my drones away. No reason to lose all of them. And this is not looking good for my poor hatchery. Not good at all. I'm trying to move in here. I want to clean this up. I want to save my natural, because that would be huge. And am I moving in? Am I moving in? I'm not moving in. Why am I not doing anything about this? Well, I think I'm waiting for my forces here, and I'm moving in with all banelings, and they just die. So that didn't go very well. And here we go, I'm going after the tanks, but they will be able to clean this off before they die. So I am now down to one base compared to his two base. And if you look here, I lost a few workers as well, and he's just chilling over there. That's neat. And his mules will help him get back into this game, and he's actually pulling ahead in the food count as well. These Mutalisks, they will have to do wonders if I'm about to win this game. And I'm not even... there we go, getting two more. Well, my natural and my third as well. And once again, I'm able to fly in here. And I'm able to snipe quite a few SCVs. Four or five, I think. So I've actually killed 23 workers. If you look at the units tab here. I'm 40 drones compared to his 33 SCV. So if I'm getting my bases up, I will be able to hopefully out macro him, but I'm still only on one hatchery. That is of course not good news at all. So I'm getting a couple of upgrades here, both for air and for my zerglings as well, and I should make sure that I inject. You should always make sure that you inject properly, but especially now. And I'm, no, I wasn't able to snipe the SV. Woohoo. Since I am so high in minerals and only one hatch, I need all the larvae I can get. And he's actually trying to drop me here, and that is annoying. But let's see how well this will go, and I will of course have to defend this in some way, and it does not look good for my benignness, but he's actually focusing, and I'm able to just kill him. One marine at a time, there we go. And he didn't really do any damage. He killed some of my zerglings, but that is it. And he's wasting 8 marines and a medevac for that, so good exchange for me. That is what I actually need, and my natural is once again up and running. My third is on the way as well, getting double gas there, and I need to start spending my money. I need to do that right now. So let's see what I have up in my sleeve here. I see that he is moving out with a formidable force here, so I'm producing 16, 18, 32 zerglings. And I'm trying to get my centrifugal hooks as well as plus 2 armor for my ground units. And I could really use quite a few more Muralisks in this game right now, you know. That would be just fly in here, snipe one or two tanks really fast and then fly away. But I do have too few to be able to do that, and he's continuing his drops. And I don't like that. There's really nothing I can do, so I'll have to try to kill this drop instead. And I am just messing up completely. I was able to kill medevac at least, and I'm producing, now I'm producing 7 more Muralisks because I could afford it. As you can see, my money is so high. I could use both 1 and 2 auxiliary hatches right now just to be able to produce things, but no. And I'm getting 1 spine crawler to protect against this force. Might not be enough, who knows. I do see that it's moving in. I'm producing a lot of banelings, and once again I am just running away with all my drones just to keep myself alive. And I am actually able to get in here, and I will be able to snipe at least one. Oh, I'm losing a lot of mutalists. 3 mutalists for one tank, not worth it. But what can you do, what can you do? And he's moving away, and that is very nice place. Going in, sniping my third. In the meantime, he's getting his third up, and this of course makes me fall even further behind. And he's not siege right now. That is a bit strange. Usually want to siege up at the towers because you can deal insane amount of damage. And there we go. I'm flying around, and he has vision of what I'm doing. And this is not a good situation to try to run into his forces there. And I'm trying to find any kind of opening with Muralisk, because I need to deal damage, and I need to do that now. And here, will I see this? Will I see this opportunity? Will I see this opportunity? I hope I do. Well, there we go. We'll actually go in here and try to deal as much damage as I can. I did see the planetary, so I was actually able to deny him some mining time. That is always good. But I cannot fight him at the planetary fortress. And it does have great splash damage, but it doesn't have friendly fire. So you can, if I run in with my marine, my zerglings around him, and his planetary shoots at my zerglings, his marines will not take damage. Siege tank, yes. Hunter seeking missiles, yes. But I think that is pretty much it. Baneling, the same banelings, they do not kill your own units, so. So at the time I'm kind of starting to fall behind. His third is up and running. My money is so stupidly high. This is just awful play. And if he just moved out with his force, he'd probably just crush me. Maybe not. But still, I'm not in a great shape here. Trying to get this, I should probably unburrow this just to save it, but it will go down, I have no idea, and that's... Oh, look at that. Huh! It survived. Poking in there, I do see a lot of towers, so I'm thinking, well, that's not the right way to go. And he's rolling down even more marines here. And I would try to go for the hive here as well, I hope. Well, finally I got myself an auxiliary hatchery, that is neat. My third is up and running, trying to get the gas as well. The main is almost mined out. Two more rounds with this drone and it will be. And I'm actually on the way with a huge counterattack. And he's just producing massive amounts of missile turrets. And of course he can afford it right now. And if you have a backdoor block here, make sure that it is closed, because surveillance in your natural is not something you want to have. As you can see, I'm able to deal a decent amount of damage here. I do see all these marines, and I decide, well, I don't have to fight that, and I just run away once again. Have to look at this. Okay. I think he should probably transfer lots of these guys up here, because he's not mining at all there, and this is so oversaturated. So he's actually not gaining that much from it. Of course, he's gaining his maximum amounts, but I think that at least if you transfer half of these guys, at least 16 or something, he will still get perfect saturation, and he could mine here as well to get even more money. As you can see, he's actually getting really, really broke right now. But he's once again moving out there. Two Thors, a couple of tanks and marines. Does not look good for my four poor mutalisks. Will I see this? He bounces away one volley and it really, really hurt. And I try to go for it. I kind of have to. I am losing a lot of units right here, right now. And he's moving in to get my natural. But this time I'm actually able to defend this quite alright, and I'm getting a lot of good hits there. And suddenly we are even on food, and I'm able to chase these tanks down as well. So three kills for me, that is always good. Get a heli on some marines here as well before my guys die. I forgot about them, so that's pretty much it. Should probably knock these down and try to get expansion up. As you can see, I'm spreading creep up this left position. That helped me get a good way to counterattack really fast. As you know, your troops are very, very fast on creep, especially Sterling's. They're insane, and he just goes down here and snipe my third once again. And I will, of course, be able to clean this up, but what does that help me right now? I once again just lost my base. I'm down to one mining base. But in the meantime, I actually got my hive. I'm getting my Great Aspire, if you look at the production tab here. And I am about to commence to one last final try here. I'm getting a lot of banings, I'm not sure why. I'm poking in here, but I see that, well, that's not the way to do damage to him. But why would you get the Great Aspire? Well, of course, you get him to get Broodlords. And that is my plan in this game. To try to get one final push out, but as you can see, I'm completely broke and getting a lot of upgrades, of course. +3, +3, and Adrenal Glance. My Sergeants will deal insane amount of damage. But if you look at these Marines, they are not upgraded at all. So my Sterlings are actually great against his Marines right now. Will be just insane. I could probably just take my Mutalisks and, well, no, not that many turrets. I just saw these three. And he's finally actually knocking down these rocks. and I will fly in here with my mutalisks. Meantime, I'm trying to make use of them since I have them. And I find this command center, and I do not want him to expand anymore. So I decide to actually go and kill it. Like that, and that of course delays him, but if you look at the food count, 184 to 136, he's so far ahead, both in food count, and, well, mainly in food count, but he's quite far ahead in, well, we're both the same in tech, but he's getting a lot of upgrades for his mech unit here. He's getting, look at that, he's actually now getting blue flames, getting plus 2, he's just getting attack upgrades, no defense. And that is of course good for my Zerglings since they deal a lot of damage and they are quite well protected right now, getting some queens, and I'm getting a 3 Bradlords. And why I'm getting them down here? Well, you want to get them as far away as possible. And here he's moving out. And will I have time to survive? I'm getting my Overlords out of the way as well. I can't afford to lose them. I'm so broke at the moment. Finally getting my third up again. And getting mine out right here. And my fourth is on the way as well. That is something I desperately need. And here we go. I'm trying to flank him with these guys. And here we go. I'm actually just wasting a lot of mutalisks there. But since he's running, I can actually afford to attack with them. And I am able to just smash his attack. And that was a huge victory for me. Mostly because I was able to, you know, not die. But as you can see, as soon as he saw that I had Bradlords, he's getting his Vikings. And that is why I need to be careful with my mutalisks here. And I'm actually continuing to press upwards here. And this is not a good angle. I should probably say right over here. Then he cannot really shoot at me. And I'm losing so many mutalisks right now. And I lost all my Bradlords. And here we go, 7 new corruptors on the way, and they will all, of course, be Bradlords when it is time and when I can afford it. And does he know? Yes, he has seen this little line of creep right there from the tower, and that, of course, tells him, well, he's probably having a base up there, and it is kind of a theme here to lose my bases. And I just decide to attack here, try to kill some of his marines because I can't run. And there we go, I just completely die. My mutalisks are on the way. Even more drones here, just going to their own death. And here we go, I will try to clean this up while the Broodlings are out. And I'm able to kill his force, but not before he kills my hatchery. So once again, I'm down to 1 mining base. And I'm still really, really struggling here. I'm so far behind. And he's getting his 4th base up and running. Really heavy saturated. He's just mined out his main, his high yield, and almost his 3rd. And his 4th is on the way. And I do not really have that right now. So that means that I'm far, far behind money-wise. And he's now trying to move out once again. And I will be able to spot this. There we go. I know what's going on. But I am now alright. I'm able to try to fight this at least. I do have quite a few Bradlords. 6 Bradlords. He's a lot of damage. I'm trying to keep my force under. Should probably bring my Zerglings as well. Zerglings and Banelings. But I do see all these Vikings. But let's see how this will go. I'm trying to use my all my mutalisks. They actually soak up quite a lot of damage, but I want to use them to kill the Vikings. And there we go, I was able to chase them away. Here we go, we'll actually try to win and snipe as much as possible. And I am able to clean this up, and in the meantime I'm getting 50 more Zerglings. Just to be able to continue this aggression. I'm getting some lag as well while recording, that is neat. And I'm going here towards his planetary fortress. And his marines are coming out here, but I will actually bring my mutalisks just to try to deal with this. I do not want to lose my Brood Leagues. Well, not my Brood Leagues either, but definitely not my Brood Lords. And here we go. I do have a lot of Zerglings, and I'm just moving down right to his fourth base with them. And I will be able to just smash all his workers right here. In the meantime, I'm keeping the pressure on his planetary fortress. And I am actually able to clean that up. If you look at the workers killed, 87 workers killed for me. That is a lot of workers killed in one game. And it's now down to this little base there mining. I was actually able to snipe the command center as well. So suddenly, because he did not really use his bases as good as he could, I am pulling ahead here for the first time in this game, and I'm getting my fourth base up and running once again, trying to spread some creep. And once again, my Broodlords died, but I'm getting some new ones here. A lot of Zerglings from behind as well. And this is not a good placement. I should probably try to move them down there. And I'm just moving in here with all my Zerglings just to stall him as much as possible, because that is what I need. But he's moving in here. I'm bringing all my queens to try to defend this. Should probably use all transfuse since I have so much energy right now. Transfuse, transfuse, transfuse. No, I lost one. Let's just use the last one here. Please. Yes, there we go, some transfuses. Too late, but still. And there is the GG. So this was a bit of a long game. It was exhausting to play. I did not play very well. But we were at about the same level, and he did some major mistakes that actually let me back in the game. I really liked how he pushed down here, just smashed my third once more and once again. So I wasn't able to build up an economy, but then he just moved everything down here, and he didn't have an economy either. And he let me in through the back door. He did not really commence with that final push just to kill me. And that allowed me to get my Broodlords up, and that is what won me the game in the end. So that was the first game, round 2 of Lost Sunday's Soda Cup. As you can see, there will be at least one more game from that cup since I won this one. It is single elimination in that cup, and it's just best of one down to the, I think it's the quarterfinals or maybe even the semifinals. So that is everything for right now. Thank you everybody, and goodbye.